Hello everyone, so welcome to the channel of RD Automation Learning. So friends, as we all know, when we are trying to clear an interview, we are having several questions in our mind, like how should I prepare my resume, what questions, what skill set should a particular software tester have to crack an interview, right? So today we have Sagar Suthar with overall 6+ years of IT experience in software testing and in various technical fields. So Sagar, a very warm welcome to you for our RD, you know, our RD Automation Learning channel, right? So yeah, friends, so Sagar, we have few questions for you that are generally asked and that are generally popping up in the minds of you know, various IT professionals who are going to start their career with the IT industry, but they are not having much idea about how they should proceed with.
Correct.
Yeah. So Sagar, shall we start with a small introduction of yourself?
Yeah, sure. So myself Sagar, and I have a total of, as you said, like 6 years of total experience in the IT industry. And I have also started my career as a fresher. I applied in the companies and I started my career. So I have a bit of experience of like how you can apply, how you can create a resume, and what are the interview processes which are going on. So I am here to like share my experience for the same.
Okay, wonderful, wonderful. So Sagar, shall we start with the first question? That is a common generic question that we would discuss is like what preparation from a fresher perspective should be done in terms of CV preparation when they are trying to crack an interview for MNC companies?
Right. So according to me, the CV or the resume which you create is the very first impression which you show to the HR. Right. You, as a person, you won't go. You will be like applying for a company and HR will be seeing your resume. So your resume should be very much precise with very much like all the technical knowledge which you have should be briefly described over it. And it should start with a career objective. Then you should briefly describe about what all technical skills which you have, and what all that technical skills which you write over there, it should be precise and you should know about it. You do not like blankly bluff like, okay, I know about this technology and I know about that technology. Whatever you write should be very much precise. Following that, since you are applying as a fresher, HR also knows like you do not have any industrial experience. So they will be judging you through the projects which you have done in your BTech. So you should briefly describe about the projects, like the live projects or some of the classroom projects or anything which you have done in your BTech. You should be briefly describing about it, how you manage that. That also in a one-liner, if you describe it in a resume, that will be very much helpful for the HR to know how technically strong you are, right? And going further, you can also add in the resume about the skills, like if you have done some Java programming in your BTech, then you can write your skill set as a Java developer or something. If you know the browse, how to create HTML web pages or something, then you can write about the HTML skills, all those things. You can highlight your scores. BTech scores are also very much important, right? So all those things you can enter in your resume. One more thing is like resume should not be too long. Some people have a habit of creating, just writing down like an essay of 4 to 5 pages of resume. That does not give a good impression. It should be like a 2 or 3 pages a short resume, which is very much easy to read. Yeah, so that's the suggestion which I have for creating a resume.
Yeah, all the points were, they were giving a proper clarity about how a CV should be prepared, right? So do we need to have some certification course in from our side to be completed if any fresher or anyone is looking for a software testing kind of a job profile basically?
See, as a fresher, if you are particularly, if you want to go for a software testing itself, then there are certain courses available like ISTQB or something. But what I suggest is like when you apply for a MNCs or something, just don't focus on a particular field. Because as a fresher, you are open to all the fields. You can go for a development, you can go for a UI, development, or you can go for a testing or anything. And as per my experience, what MNC companies do is, they will just call the freshers they will be selecting, reading the resumes and selecting them. They will be taking the aptitude test and then conducting two rounds of interviews. Once that interview is done, then on the basis of the interview, the company itself will decide whether that candidate is perfect for which field, whether they want to take them for development, whether they want to take their candidate for testing or what. So what I suggest is, like, if you are applying as a fresher, just be open for all the fields, not only focus on software testing. That's what my suggestion is. But yes, if you want to still go for a software testing part, there are certifications available like ISTQB. You can go for it. It will add a benefit for the selection.
So ISTQB foundation level and advanced level both are available.
Yeah.
And basically, if we are starting for a fresher level, if we are thinking from a fresher level perspective, then I think foundation level would be a beneficial
foundation level course.
And it would add a value also to their career, right? Because these days, if you would see software testing jobs, job opportunities are growing in the market. And if somebody has an experience of completion of certification as well, then it would be an additional value.
It will be add-on to, it will be like a add-on for the extra benefit for them.
Definitely. So moving to further question is, what kind of behavioral question are asked in an interview? When we are going for face-to-face, and all those.
So as I already mentioned, right, so whenever you apply for an interview, they will be conducting an aptitude test. So very first thing is to clear your aptitude. Once you clear that, there will be several rounds of interviews, like technical round, HR round, and so on. Managerial round will be there. So coming to the behavioral type of question. So if you see a technical round, mostly the interviewer will focus on the technical skills which you have. He will be asking you about the programming and everything. And that time, other than behavioral, how you give the answer. The interviewer also know, like, you are a fresher, you do not have an industrial experience. So in a while you might go nervous, like you are like, while answering the questions, you might go nervous or something. So you should be like starting your interview with some ice-breaking sessions. Like, you should introduce yourself first. And that would give a positive approach to the interviewer. Okay, like, this candidate is having a strong communication skills as well. And the main part is your attitude. How you, like in the interview, how you are answering the questions which is asked by the interview without getting being nervous or something like that. So that's how the technical round goes. Coming to the HR round. HR round will be very much normal. Won't go for last. It will be like 5 or 10 minutes session with HR. And he will be just asking you about the locations and everything, and coming to the salary discussions and everything. So in the HR round as well, as per my experience, HR also focuses more on how eager you are to join their institute, what all knowledge you have about their institute. If you are applying, for example, say Accenture, I take the company of Accenture. The HR may ask you, like, how you come to know about Accenture, what all things you know about Accenture or something like that. So you must be prepared for that as well, so that you can answer them easily.
Mm-hmm. Right. Yeah, I agree fully, 100% I agree with you, because the HRs are very keen to know, like, from where the information went to the people from their side. So we should always recommend people to go through their websites, read the websites, know about the business, what they are into. And once you are able to answer these questions to the HR, definitely it would be 100% sure for them. Okay, Sagar. So that was the wonderful answer from your side. So our moving to the next question is, like, what is the preparation that you think should be done if we want to clear a written test? Because cracking an interview would be on a later stage, but first individual would have to clear the written test, right? So what preparation should be done from that aspect?
Yes. So considering the MNCs, right, they will be mostly doing a pool drives. They will be calling thousands of students at a particular location.
Mm-hmm.
And they will be selecting those locations, That was like happening during my time. Like they were calling all the students at one location, and then they were conducting the interview. So selecting the students from them, from the big pool, was a difficult part. So they will be conducting the aptitude test for, that is a mandatory part. Aptitude tests have to be cleared so that it will be easy for the company as well to bifurcate between the students, like which they want to select and which they do not want to select. So clearing the aptitude is a very important part for getting a job into MNC as a fresher, right? So aptitude tests mostly will be conducting about the quantitative aptitude, then coming to the linear algebra, probability, permutations and combinations. And sometimes, depending on the company which you're applying for, they also conduct group discussions, or they will be also asking you to do an essay writing or something. So your writing skills should be very much precise. Your group discussions, so they will be giving you the topics which are about the current affairs and all those things. So keep reading news and what's happening around the world about the current affairs and everything. That will really help for the group discussions. And for the aptitude test, it will be just an online MCQ test with around 50 questions or something. And as I mentioned, it will be about the quantitative aptitude, then linear algebra and all those things. So there are many books and YouTube videos available which can help you to learn about it. And what I say is, like, just practice makes a man perfect. So just keep on practicing about the all the aptitudes and your mathematics and everything. This will really help you to clear out those tests.
Definitely. So are there any possibilities that are coming up from the companies that for the eligibility criteria for 10th standard or 12th standard, do they need some certain sort of percentages to be, you know, available from the candidate side? Like some companies are asking, like TCS or Wipro, that 60% should be scored right in 10th as well as 12th. So are those things also coming into the picture when you are going for an interview, or it is just?
So first of all, whenever any company comes to your campus for a pool drive or something, or whenever you apply explicitly, they will be asking for your scores of 10th standard and 12th standard. Okay. So 60% is required in both 10th and 12th. It should be more than 60%. And the third criteria is like, all your BTEC examination should be clear. There should not be any KT or anything should be pending over there. So these three criteria are the very, very primary criteria to just appear for your first round, that is aptitude.
Okay. So what are the key skills required if a person wants to get into a software testing job profile? So any key skills that would be required from his side or her side?
Okay. So specifically speaking to the software testing part, right? And you are going as a fresher. So for example, you must have completed your BTEC from computer science or something. You must be aware about software development as well. And you must have learned about the software testing concept as well. So the key skills, what I say is like, you must, there is, as a interviewer also know, there is, you do not have any industry experience about anything since you are a fresher. So you must have not, if you do not have a deep knowledge about it, that is fine. But a basic knowledge will help you out. Just like, what is a SDLC, what is a STLC, right? What are different methodologies of software development, like waterfall method, agile method, right? So all those theoretical concepts which you have, just go through it once. That will be really helpful for your cracking the interview.
So thank you, Sagar. It was a wonderful interaction with you. Right? Any other things that you would like to add?
So that's what I want to add. Prepare yourself best. Keep practicing about the aptitude. Read. And what I would like to say is, like, whenever you apply, whenever you go for an interview, don't panic. Interviewer won't eat you up. He will just ask you a few questions and you have to answer them. Just start with the ice-breaking session with them. So it will be really helpful. So that's what I wanted to add.
Yeah. So thank you, Sagar. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.